I think we complain enough because Blackmagic just gave us what we was asking for, a boxed out cinema camera. Honestly, the Blackmagic Pixel 6K looks incredible. If you guys know me from this channel, I started my channel with the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K, which honestly, that was one of my favorite cameras ever that I've owned. And I'm so sad that, you know, it died. That was my, you know, reasons for getting the Red Komodo. But this camera takes too much to get it started, turn it on, black shade. Well, get it started, wait to get warm to the right temperature, then black shade. So I'm kind of done with that. I don't want to do that no more. I want to turn on the camera and just record. And hey, I was very tired, as much as you was, of the brick form of the pocket cinema camera style. But now we got the Pixis. Honestly, this Pixis, I'm looking at my iPad, it looks incredible. You have the panel on the side, which have all your buttons and the screen. It looks very professional. It looks more appealing if you want to take it to a job. The camera looks cool. It won't look like your mom's picture taking camera. And the viewfinder looks amazing. Honestly, it looks very, very good. A lot of people have mixed thoughts about it. They're saying that without the viewfinder, it's going to be hard to operate this camera. But I don't think so. Honestly, I think, you know, you're always going to get your monitor of choice and put it on top like most people do. And yeah, and you can just operate it there. So they eliminated the HDMI. Finally, now it's SDI. So now we can say it's a professional cinema camera. But yeah, some people might want it, you know, both. I mean, I wouldn't mind if it was there. I mean, I have monitors that are SDI, so it's not a problem for me. But the fact that, you know, this camera is the same as the Blackmagic 6K full frame that they dropped, but in a box form, is just mind blowing. Everybody knows that camera, the new one, it's amazing. The image quality is like up to par with the Ursa, but honestly, looks really good. Now you can actually mount it to a gimbal properly and, you know, take it anywhere with, you know, with the easy form factor. And also, a box form camera that you can use the full sensor open gate. So if you're doing your anamorphic, you get the whole screen. It's just like, this camera is just insane. And yeah, they dropped the bigger camera, which is the Ursa, but that's for the big boys. You know, that's if you're doing like more high-end movie productions. But for us, the content creators, the YouTubers, the, you know, indie filmmakers, I think this camera is gonna be a hot seller. I'm going to try to wait for Monday to get rid of my Red Komodo, because like I said, I don't use it. I use more of the Sony, and get some money back and actually put a pre-order on this camera. I know I'm gonna lose out. This camera is a $6,000 camera with taxes, is like $6,500, but the resale value on these cameras are horrible. Nobody wants to buy these used. I don't know why. It's a great camera. Yeah, I mean, I love it. It looks amazing. The image quality, it's cool. But like I said, I don't like a camera that I have to do too much to operate it. But it is what it is. Another thing that I actually want to, that I'm hoping, because I'm looking at the screen right now with where the sensor is at with the mount, it looks like you can be able to interchange the mount system. So, you know, they have the REPL, they have the EF, and they have the L. I would like to go first now with the EF, being that I have a lot of EF lenses. But if it's not possible to change, I will definitely go for the PL. So I have my good friend, YouTuber Say Park. What up, Say? He's gonna actually check out for me on NAB. He's going. I wish I can go, but I couldn't. But to see if you could go to a Blackmagic booth, confirm that you can swap the mounts. So if I can, if you can do that, then I'm gonna opt for the EF. So I can't wait for tomorrow, because tomorrow is when he goes in. It's April 14, it starts. So can't wait to get to that response. So yeah, and another thing that I wanted to talk about is that, yeah, there's no internal NDs. It might be a mine thing for people, like, oh, every cinema camera must have a variable ND, and like, yeah, I understand, it's very helpful, it's very cool, it's very, you know, useful instead of screwing on, I understand. But if you know you are going to use this camera for, let's say, a professional shoot, and you're only thinking about time against, you know, quality, then you shouldn't be filming it. Honestly, just go there, prep. If you have six lenses that you're going to use, just make sure they're all mounted. And all you have to do is just buy more ND. I don't care. I will buy more NDs and just have every mount just, you know, lens ready. Because if you're getting you're going to get money out of that production. How much is to get a few NDs? Like, come on, let's be serious, bro. Or we can just get a few, you know, adapters, you know, step-up rings, whatever, and just configure for whatever lens you have. Like, that's what I do. I never looked at it as a problem, but some people are like very anal about stuff like that. But yeah, so like I said before, you got three models to choose from. PL, locking EF, finally, because that EF on the old Blackmagic 6K, I don't know if you guys had that same problem like me, it will become loose after a while. And you know, I almost dropped my 18 to 35 once, and I was like, oh my god, you know. But hey, it's locking, it's good, it is there. So yeah, I can't wait. They saying they're gonna drop this in June, and I just can't wait. The only thing that I'm like still like skeptical, not skeptical of the camera, because these cameras produce an amazing image regardless of the dynamic range, but I mean, how long Blackmagic is gonna keep dropping these 13 stops of dynamic range in these cameras? They should have upgraded at least 15. You know, some people might say, ah, you're not gonna see much of a difference. Like I understand that, but it's good to know, peace of mind, that is there, that you have 16 stops of dynamic range as opposed to 13 since day one they've been dropping it. I guess they're saving that for their Ursa. Maybe that's the only protection they have against, so people just buy the Ursa. But we all know every time they drop an Ursa, like the first 12K, well, the second edition, not the G2. You guys remember that thing was like $10,000, and it dropped to $6,500 because people were not buying it. So I don't wish that on their new one, but most likely a lot of people are going to pick the Pixis. I think the Blackmagic cinema camera cameras, those are like their bread and butter. So I think they should have at least 15 stops of dynamic range. And thank God they got rid of that MPF. Now is a BP battery, which they last super long. Like right now, when I use my Red Komodo, if I don't want to use the V mount, I normally just put one, and it lasts, you know, 2 hours for me enough. So when I have two, I'll be there like 3.5, almost 4 hours with these two BP batteries, because this is a low power consumption camera, and that's what they designed this camera to be, a low power consumption camera, which is great. You know, you don't have to deal with that. Another thing is you get frame rates that a lot of cameras don't have. So you get a whole bunch of variety, which is super great, as opposed to something like this. This is why that they upgraded and they made the Komodo X. The biggest shine from the Komodo X, obviously, you guys know, is the frame rate capability. They say it's a cleaner shadow and skin tones, but honestly, I don't know. Some people, my friend has a Komodo X, and we put it against each other, and he was like, they look the same. But hey, that's another topic. But yeah, we have frame rates, we have slow motion, which is good. I'm not gonna go into details, you guys already know, you guys watch a whole million videos on this. But honestly, man, the Pixis looks amazing. If you guys are gonna upgrade to get this camera, let me know in the comments. If you're gonna do one of me, honestly, I look at it like an upgrade. I know this camera is worth more money, and it's a Red, obviously, the image quality, they've done movies with this cameras. This camera, there's no introduction for it. You guys seen a few movies that they film with this. And but like I said before, I need a camera that is a grab and go, and that is it. So yeah, this is gonna be it for me. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. Subscribe to the channel, keep showing the love, like the video. Thank you for all the comments I've been getting lately. Hopefully, you know, you guys can stay for the ride. So take care, peace.